Hi everyone, I'm Shireen and welcome to my channel. I'm an English teacher and this is where we talk about all things related to the English language. Now, today is Valentine's Day, so let's take this opportunity to look at some expressions and phrases to describe your love life, the person that you love, and your feelings. As you probably already know, Valentine's Day takes place on February 14th, and this holiday has come to be seen as a Hallmark holiday. Now, Hallmark is a greeting card company in the United States, and it's kind of the shop where you would go to buy a card for someone for any occasion. And when we call a holiday a Hallmark holiday, it's quite negative. It means that the holiday is driven by commercial purposes. So companies encourage you to buy things and give gifts. This is a way to say that the holiday has kind of lost its traditional or historical significance. We call it a Hallmark holiday. This is a day when you're intended to express your love. And the most typical ways for you to express your love on Valentine's Day in the United States would be to buy a greeting card, buy a box of chocolates, buy flowers, and maybe arrange a fancy dinner for the person that you love. You'll see a lot of lovey-dovey couples during this time. Now, lovey-dovey is a term we use to say affectionate or romantic. A lovey-dovey couple. This is informal. Some people don't care about Valentine's Day at all, whether they're in a relationship or not. But for others who are perhaps going through a rough patch in their relationship, this could be a difficult, depressing day. A rough patch in a relationship describes a time when perhaps you're arguing a lot, maybe even thinking about separating from one another. But the idea of this phrase, a rough patch, is that it's just a patch. It's a short term. You're going to get over it. Other people who might find this holiday to be depressing are people who have suffered heartbreak, who have had their hearts broken. This is a phrase that we use to describe a person who has been hurt by the person that they love. So it means that they are so hurt that it feels like their heart is broken. But luckily, you can mend a broken heart. So someone with a broken heart could potentially meet someone else who helps them mend their broken heart. Or, even better, they can mend their broken heart on their own. To mend means to fix, so to fix the broken heart. Imagine that you have a heart that's broken into two pieces, so it's a broken heart, and you're going to mend it, you're going to fix it. There are a lot of ways to describe your love life. So your love life is that part of your life that concerns your romantic relationships. Perhaps the most obvious ones are you're either single or you're married or you're in a relationship. But there are many other ways that you could describe your love life. You could be into someone. So that means you're not in a relationship with the person. You're just interested in the person. You're into someone. So I could say to a friend of mine, "What do you think of him? I think he's really into you." Another way you could describe your relationship is to say, it's complicated. If you say it's complicated, that means that you're not single, but you're in a situation that is complicated. It's actually a really polite way to say to someone, I'm not single, but I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to give you any more details. If you ask someone, are you in a relationship? And they say, it's complicated. That means I don't really want to talk about it, but I'm not single. And if you are in a serious relationship, a committed relationship, this means that you're in a relationship with someone and you're not interested in anyone else, this is your person, you would say, I'm taken. I'm taken. So if someone says, oh, are you in a relationship? Or if somebody asks you out on a date, you could say, I'm sorry, I'm taken. That means you're either married or you're in a serious relationship with someone. Let's take a look at some really endearing ways to describe the person that you love. The first one is my one and only. I love this one. It's really romantic. It's a nice way to say that you're the only person for me. My one and only. You can say this to someone else too when talking about your partner. So you could say, oh, yep, she's my one and only. I don't want anybody else. Another way to describe the person that you love is to call them your soulmate. Your soulmate is the person that is meant for you. Now, it's the idea that in this universe, there are a whole lot of people, but this one person is meant for you. Your souls are mates. Now, not everyone agrees. Some people think that there's no such thing as soulmates, and other people think, yeah, I've found my soulmate. Let me know in the comments if you believe that soulmates exist, that there is just one person in this universe who is intended for another. Now, the next one is a really common one when it comes to introducing the person that you love. You can introduce them by saying, this is my better half, or this is my other half. This is the idea that you and your loved one make one whole. So you are half and your partner is the other half. And you describe your partner as your better half or your other half. You could also describe the person that you love as that special someone. That special someone. You'll hear this a lot actually in advertising when it comes to Valentine's Day. Why don't you buy a bouquet of flowers for that special someone? That means the person that you love, the person that you're interested in, the person that you're into. And if you think that you've met the person that you want to be with forever, you could call them Mr. Right or Mrs. Right. So imagine that you're talking with your friend and you could say, I think I found Mr. Right. That means the person I want to spend the rest of my life with, the perfect man. I think I found Mr. Right. He's definitely Mr. Right. If you see a couple and you think that they are just perfect together, you could say they are made for each other. Made for each other. Another way to say that is they are a match made in heaven. A match made in heaven. That means they are perfect together. Not just like they look perfect together, but everything about the way they interact with one another is perfect. They're a good team. They're a match made in heaven. They're made for each other. Here are some ways to talk about your romantic feelings. You can fall in love with someone. If you fall in love with someone, that means that you have become romantically attached to that person. You love them so much, you fall in love with someone. And on the other side of that, you can also fall out of love with someone. So sadly, sometimes in relationships, people who were once in love, they fell in love at one time, have after time fallen out of love. You can also be love sick. If you're love sick, that means that your love for someone is affecting you and making you feel sick. Not necessarily physically sick, although it could be, but it's affecting your behavior or the way that you act. Maybe you can't get anything done because you can't stop thinking about the person that you love. Maybe you're missing the person that you love. We call this love sickness. So you're love sick. This is another one that some people believe in and some people definitely don't. It's love at first sight. So love at first sight is the idea that you can love someone from the moment that you see them. So let's imagine you're talking to a couple and you say, when did you know that you had feelings for her? The other person could say, it was love at first sight. So from the moment I saw her, I loved her. What about you? Do you believe in love at first sight? Can you love someone from the second that you see them?
I don't know.
You can also be madly in love with someone. Madly in love with someone. That means that you are deeply in love with that person. Another way you could say this is to be head over heels for someone. To be head over heels for someone. To be head over heels in love with someone is quite an intense one. It means that you are completely in love with that person. You can also be love struck. If you're love struck, it's like love came and it hit you. So if you're love struck, you are intensely in love with someone. So we've learned all these lovely ways to say that you love someone, that you're in love with someone, to describe the feelings of love. But what about if you're blinded by love? To be blinded by love isn't really a good thing. To be blind means to not be able to see. So if you're blinded by love, that means that you're unable to see the other person's faults. And perhaps you stop doing things for yourself and you devote all your time to this person who isn't maybe a very good person. That is to be blinded by love. That's something that we definitely want to avoid. As I said at the start of this video, a lot of people don't really like Valentine's Day because it's a Hallmark holiday. It's a commercial holiday. Let me know in the comments, do you like Valentine's Day? Do you celebrate Valentine's Day in your country? Is it a commercial holiday in your country? If you'd like to learn more English with me, please consider subscribing to my channel and watch some of my other videos, which I'll link at the end. And find me on Instagram. I post lots of learning content there, and it's all interactive. You get to answer questions, practice your English. See you next time. Bye!